scriptures in the Bible that says the righteous this, the righteous have this. This is what that's talking about you. This is your inheritance. This is your benefit package. Not because of what you've done, but because of what Jesus has done for you. So here we go. Number one, complete acceptance and approval before God. That's the benefit or reward of being declared righteous. You are completely accepted and approved before God. Do you know people live their whole life seeking approval? Their whole life, they're seeking approval. They need approval because honestly, God put that need within us to be approved of. And you have been given complete and utter approval by the King of Kings. Nobody else's approval matters. Amen. Nobody else's opinion matters. When you realize you've been made righteous in Jesus and it's a pure gift, you know you're approved by your Heavenly Father forever. There ain't nothing you can do for Him to disapprove of you. If you are in Christ, you are approved forever. Number two, blessed in every area of your life. You know those Deuteronomy chapter 28 blessings that I tried so hard to qualify for about 20 years ago. I tried so hard because it says if you obey all the commands of God, if you obey all the law, all these blessings will come upon you. And so I tried really hard to obey all the law. But guess what? I found out that I have been entitled to all the advantages and benefits and rewards as though I perfectly obeyed the law because of Jesus. So now I can go back to Deuteronomy chapter 28 and see what the benefit package is. I'm blessed when I come in. I'm blessed when I go out. Everything I put my hand to prospers. A surplus of prosperity comes upon the righteous. The fruit of my womb is blessed. Woo! I'm the head and not the tail. I'm above and not beneath. I'm the lender and not the borrower. Because that's the benefits and rewards of being declared righteous before God. Woo! We're blessed. You know what the word blessed means in Hebrew? Anointed and empowered to prosper. That's what it means. When the Lord blesses you, and He does in Christ, He has anointed you and He has empowered you to prosper in every area of your life. Ooh, prosperity, Proverbs 13:21, prosperity is the reward of the righteous. Are you righteous?
Yes.
Then prosperity is your reward. Amen. Health and renewed youth. Don't we all want that? Yes. That's the benefit of being declared righteous. Health and renewed youth. Favor and guidance, for surely, O Lord, you bless the righteous. You surround them with the favor, with your favor, as with a shield. Financial abundance, this is one of my favorites. Psalms 37, 17 and 19, the Lord sustains the righteous. They will not be ashamed in the time of evil, and in the days of famine they will have abundance. You know what? I just love how the Lord has given me such a revelation that when the economy is down, I'm going to prosper because I've been declared righteous in Jesus. When I hear, you know what, most people, Christians included, will listen to the news, the economy's down, people are losing their jobs. When I watch that, I go, yippee, I'm going to prosper. No, I mean, I'm not happy that people are losing their jobs. Don't get that wrong. But do you understand what I'm saying? Instead of what we don't go, you know, honestly, we're not worried about other people. We're worried about ourselves. When we hear the bad economy news, we're like, oh, those poor. We're like, oh my gosh, how's that going to affect me? I might lose my job. My business might go down. Oh no. Come on. Yes. We're thinking about me. But when I hear the economy is down, there's famine in the land, I remember Psalms 37. And it says, in the time of famine, the righteous will have abundance. And do you know that that is exactly what has happened in my life? The manifestation of that promise has happened in my life. I mean, starting back in 2000, 9/11, when all that happened, I mean, me and my household have prospered and prospered and prospered and increased. That is the truth of what's happened in Connie's life. And the only thing that I can say is, focus on Jesus. You want to know the secret? It's just focus on Jesus. Instead of me going around going, oh my gosh, how is this going to affect me? Because if I do, guess what? It's going to affect me. If I go around in condemnation thinking, oh no, God's not going to take care of me. What if I lose my job? I'm going to lose everything. Guess what's going to happen? Exactly what you're thinking. Because you are condemning yourself. You're condemning yourself. Okay? But when you hear the economy's going down, people are losing their jobs. My husband lost his job. Okay, so I'm not saying you might not lose your job. My husband lost his job, but guess what? 2 months later, his income doubled. 2 months later, thank God he lost his job. Okay, so you may. I'm not saying you're not going to lose your job. I'm not saying that you might not experience some negative situation that you're facing, because I did. I looked square in the face at, this is going to affect you, Connie, and it's going to affect you bad, okay? I looked square in the face at it, and I ran to Jesus. Amen. And I said, Jesus, what do you say? Tell me one more time, Lord, what you say, because all these people around me are afraid. I don't want to live in fear. I want to live in peace. I want to live by faith. I want to live by relying on you, Jesus, and not myself. And he said, Connie, I said, my plan was to prosper you. My plan was to give you a hope and a future. All grace abounds towards you, Connie. That's your benefit for being righteous. That's your reward for me declaring you righteous in Christ. And I said, thank you, Jesus. And my mind stayed on, thank you, Jesus. In the time of famine, the righteous prosper, Lord. And you said, I'm righteous. Because of Jesus. And it happened. When you live with a condemned heart, you do live in shame and guilt and pain. You do. Even though Jesus set you free, you live there. I know, because I did. But when you turn and you realize you're righteous in Christ, you're blessed, you're favored, how exciting is that? Even when you're looking square in the face at a circumstance that tells you it's not true, you say, Jesus, you made me righteous. Even when let's say you have a business and you had a great month, and the next month it's down, you look at that circumstance square in the face and you don't go, what am I doing wrong? I must be doing something wrong, because I had a great month last month, but this month I'm down. I must be doing something wrong, you know? Right? Isn't that how we are tending to do? No, you look at that down square in the face and you go, Jesus, you made me righteous. I am blessed because of you. I am not defined by whether or not I had a great month or whether I had a bad month. I am defined by Jesus and his righteousness. And I am blessed going in and I'm blessed going out. And I will not believe the circumstances. I'm telling you what, this is living by relying on Jesus. This is living. This is what it looks like. This is what I'm telling you, Romans chapter 4. Living by relying upon Jesus. The promise is guaranteed to those who rely upon Jesus. The rewards, the benefits, the fruit of righteousness is guaranteed. in the life of the person who will rely upon Jesus. Turn to him when you're facing negative circumstances. Turn to him. Ask him for his grace to help you trust him. Listen to what he tells you who you are. Your circumstances do not define you. Your past mistakes do not define you. The enemy uses your past mistakes and your present circumstances to tell you you're doing something wrong. You aren't doing anything wrong. The only thing truly we can be doing wrong, if you want to talk about doing wrong, is focusing on ourselves. That's it. So it's not about all of the stuff out here. It's about what's going on in here. Who are you looking to for your righteousness? Yourself? Are you looking to Jesus? Because when you look to Jesus, you're going to live in peace. You're going to live in joy. And you're going to experience the benefits and rewards of the righteous. For it's guaranteed to all who rely upon Jesus. Deliverance and victory in every situation, number 7. Number 8, a joyful and peaceful heart and home. Number 9, children who live in the truth and have great peace. That's a benefit and reward of perfect obedience that you've been given in Christ. Righteousness. Number 10, false accusations against you will not prosper. I love that one. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. For he who rises against you in judgment shall be shown to be in the wrong. For this vindication is of the Lord for the righteous. Praise God. I've stood on that one a plenty of time. Number 11, powerful and effective prayers. For the prayer of the righteous is powerful and effective. One step to powerful prayers. Righteousness. You're righteous. Your prayers are powerful. Believe it. Believe it. Rely upon Jesus. And protection. He has given his angels charge over us to protect us in all our ways. Amen? The rewards and benefits of being made righteous. If you embraced every one of those things that I just shared with you, you'd be one happy person. The promise and benefits of righteousness are guaranteed to those who share the faith of Abraham. The following verses give us a clear picture of what it looks like to live by faith, relying upon Jesus for salvation. As it is written, verse 17, I have made you the father of many nations. He was appointed our father in the sight of God in whom he believed, who gives life to the dead and speaks of non-existent things as if they already existed. For Abraham, human reason for hope being gone, hoped in faith that he would become the father of many nations as he had been promised. So numberless shall your descendants be. He did not weaken in faith when he considered the utter impotence of his own body, which was as good as dead, because he was about 100 years old, or when he considered the barrenness of Sarah's dead and womb. No unbelief or distrust made him waver, doubtingly question concerning the promise of God, but he grew strong and was empowered by faith as he gave praise and glory to God, fully satisfied and assured that God was able and mighty to keep his word and to do what he had promised. Now listen to this in the message. I love it. Verse 19 through 21. Abraham didn't focus on his own impotence and say it's hopeless. This 100-year-old body could never father a child, nor did he survey Sarah's decades of infertility and give up. He didn't tiptoe around God's promise, asking cautiously skeptical questions. He plunged into the promise and he came up strong, ready for God, sure that God would make good on what he had said. For many, many years of my Christian life, I tiptoed around God's promises, asking cautiously skeptical questions. Well, if this is true, see, what did the father say to Abraham? I have made you the father of many nations. I have made you righteous. But Abraham's circumstances looked hopeless. What the father said about Abraham did not look true. Abraham chose to not be defined by his present circumstances. He chose to be defined by what his father said about him. It doesn't matter what it looks like. If the father says you're blessed, if the father says you're favored, if the father says your children are taught of the Lord and obedient to his will, if the father says his righteousness will be with your children's children and your children will rise up and call you blessed because you've been made righteous in Jesus, then guess what? That is exactly what is true about you, despite your circumstances. Healed. That's right. If your body is screaming at you that you're not healed, that doesn't define you. Your circumstances do not define you. What the Father says defines you. You are not defined by your past mistakes, and you are not defined by your present circumstances. You are defined by the righteousness that's been given to you in Christ Jesus. You are defined by what the Father says about you. When Abraham was empowered by faith by giving praise and glory to God, that word glory means the Father's good opinion. Abraham was glorifying God by agreeing with what the Father said about him. He was giving praise and glory to God, saying, Father, if you say I'm righteous, then I'm righteous. If you say I'm blessed, then I'm blessed. That's what it means to give glory to God. We think giving glory to God is all these things we have to do, but it's about what you believe. You give glory to God when you believe what the Father says about you, no matter what your financial situation, no matter what your body's screaming at you, no matter what your children are acting like, no matter who's saying mean things about you, no matter if you lost your job or the economy's going down, you believe what the Father says because that's where your identity is. What does it mean to rely upon Jesus? What does it mean to live by faith? It means your past mistakes do not define you. Your present circumstances do not define you. Your identity is not in your failures. Your identity is not in your present circumstances. You don't go, well, my body says I'm sick, so I'm sick. No, my Father says I'm healed in Jesus. My Father says I'm blessed in Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father, for making me righteous. Thank you that my present circumstances does not change the truth that I am holy and righteous and qualified and approved because of Jesus. Self-focused is defining yourself by your past mistakes and your present circumstances. That's being self-focused. Jesus-focused is, it doesn't matter what mistakes I've made. It doesn't matter what my circumstances are screaming at me. I am identified. I am defined by what Jesus did for me in making me righteous as a gift of grace. I am righteous in Jesus. I am blessed. I'm going to tell you, when I first started learning this, my whole life didn't look like those 12 things. My whole life was just, I'm telling you, I can't even explain how sad I was. My marriage was a mess. My financial situation was a mess. My self-image, I just was sad. I didn't even have any real friendships because I put up a wall. You can't have a real friendship until you get heart to heart with someone. And you can't get heart to heart with someone until you realize your past mistakes don't define you. So I can tell you all my crap, and it doesn't matter what you think. And those who stay after they know my crap, I'm sorry if that offends you. If those who remain my friend after they know all my failures and mistakes, guess what? They're the real friend. So find out who your real friends are. Tell them. Because it doesn't define you. It does not define you. Your past mistakes, I don't care how big of a mistake or failure it was, It is gone. You're not, that's not even attached to you. That's not who you are anymore. But I'm telling you, every area of my life was not what God said it was. I don't even know if I had one promise operating in me. I don't know. But I'm telling you what, God still said the same thing about me. He did. He was saying all along, Connie, you're righteous in Jesus. Connie, you're blessed. Connie, your children are blessed. Connie, you have peace in your home. Connie, you have joy in your heart. Connie, you're healed. Connie, you're wonderful. Connie, you're approved. Connie, you're favored. Connie, the Father was saying and saying it and saying it over me, but I was going, no, 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 it's not true. It's not true. The turning point in my life came when I gave up the lie and embraced the truth that it didn't matter what my past mistakes were and it didn't matter what my present circumstances was screaming at me. I wasn't going to cautiously tiptoe around God's promises asking skeptical questions anymore. I was going to plunge right into it. Jesus, if you did this for me as a pure gift of your grace, I embrace it. And I began to glorify God, and I haven't stopped glorifying God since. There are times I get discouraged, and there are times my focus gets off, but guess where? I know where to run, because immediately when I feel those negative emotions rising up in me, I know where my focus has turned. It's turned in. And so I know to turn to Jesus. The one who lives inside of me, the one who made me righteous. And I begin glorifying God once again. Lord, I thank you that you made me righteous. I thank you that you love me. I thank you that I'm blessed coming in and coming out. I thank you that my children are mighty and blessed upon the earth. I thank you, Lord, that you're teaching my children and they have great peace. I thank you that you've given your angels charge over them and protecting them in all their ways. I thank you, Father, that you love me and what you say about me is true. And that's how I live every day. I live thinking upon what Jesus did for me. And when I do, I have peace, I have joy, and I have love for people that only comes from God. You want to live abundant life? Don't tiptoe around God's promises anymore, asking skeptical, cautious questions. But what about this? What about that? What about this situation? But what about them? But what about, do you hear what I'm saying? Asking skeptical questions will keep you in the self-focused, condemning, shame-filled, discouraged life. Give it up. If the Father says it, it is true, and it is finished for you and for me. We are blessed. We are righteous. We are justified. We are perfect and holy and righteous in God's sight. Let's start glorifying God. Let's start living by faith in Jesus. Let's live in the abundant life he came to give us. Let's turn to him in every negative circumstance and say, Father, what do you say? Because what you say is what defines me, not what I'm staring at. Hallelujah. Amen. Oh, thank you, Jesus. And I end with this. Verses 22 through 25. That is why his faith was credited to him as righteousness. But the words it was credited to him were written not for his sake alone, but they were written for our sakes too. Righteousness, standing acceptable and approved before God, will be granted and credited to us all who believe in, trust in, and hear and rely on God who raised Jesus our Lord from the dead, who was betrayed and put to death because of our misdeeds and was raised to secure our justification, our acquittal, making our account balance, absolving us from all guilt before God. Jesus died to save you from the penalty of your sin, and he rose again to secure your righteousness forever.
Hallelujah.
That's what Jesus did. The turning point in our lives will be when we take our focus off of ourselves and turn our focus to Jesus. Taking off your focus on what you need to do or what you've done wrong to what Jesus did to make you right. Pure joy is the fruit of focusing on Jesus.
Awake to righteousness. You are qualified, innocent, forgiven, accepted, approved, and loved. Join Connie Witter as she takes you on a grace-filled journey through the book of Romans and discover what being righteous in Jesus truly means. Get your personal copy of Awake to Righteousness, also available as a group Bible study package. Call 918-994-6500 or visit conniewitter.com to order or download your copy today.
Because of Jesus Ministries introduces our first children's storybook, Are You a Chickenhead? By Connie Witter. This fun little book asks the big life question, what's true about you?
Mommy, that girl called me a chickenhead.
Is that true, Victoria? Are you a chickenhead? What does Jesus say about you? For many years, I have shared this true story to encourage others to believe what Jesus says about them. I pray this book will inspire parents, grandparents, and children alike to confidently respond,
I believe what Jesus says about me.
Order this delightful book today. Call 918-994-6500 or go online at becauseofjesus.com, where Bible studies are always in the light of Jesus.
Hi, I'm Connie Witter, and I want to thank the partners of Because of Jesus Ministries for making it possible to bring this TV broadcast to your local station. It is my heart's desire to see people set free from religious rules and laws that tell them they have to do something to be approved and blessed by God. The truth is, Jesus came and made us righteous and good and qualified for all of God's blessings as a gift of His grace. It is time that the world knows the true heart of our Father and His goodness and love and grace toward them in Jesus. I invite you to help us reach the world with this good news. You can become a partner today by visiting us online at conniewitter.com, or you can give by your phone through text to give. Text the word GIVE to 918-218-2023. Together, we will change the world with the gospel of grace.
Because of Jesus Ministries is your resource for grace-filled, Jesus-focused Bible studies and curriculum for all ages. Adult Bible studies, books, devotionals for girls and teens, DVDs, CDs, and MP3s. We offer group Bible study packages as well. Connect with us and check out our many free resources online at conniewitter.com, where Bible studies are always in the light of Jesus.